everyone. This is 22 Tiger Dude, and welcome to Q&A and the Summertime. So, if you guys saw the video I made in the beginning of June, I gave you all a month and a half to ask me questions for Q&A in the Summertime, because I did a Q&A to celebrate 300 subscribers, and that was a lot of fun. I did a four-part Q&A video for my 700th video, and now to celebrate summertime, here is my Q&A. Now, before I do get started on this Q&A, I just want to say July 27th marks my two-year anniversary. So not only am I celebrating the summertime, but this is, you could say, my celebration for me being here on YouTube for 2 years. I want to take the time to thank everyone for supporting me. I'm at pretty much 900 subscribers now, and seriously, just thanks for the support, you guys. I really want to thank you guys so much, and I want to thank Abner Solano. He's the one that made me those 22 Tiger Dude images. Abner actually offered to make me those. He just really surprised me. I'm like, hey man, I love your image. I love the creativity of it. So Abner, I want to thank you so much, man. And those Tiger Dude images, they're just the best. And I gotta take off these sunglasses because, you know, I can't see the questions from here. So, yeah. The first questions are actually from J53518. Now, you guys, if you don't know who he is, he's actually a very good buddy of mine. I went to high school with him. He has his own channel as well, and he has Anime Chat Mondays with J53518 here on this 22 Tiger Dude channel. It's every Monday, anime stuff from him. It's really cool. Check it out if you haven't. The questions from him are, can you review an episode of the anime Squid Girl? I honestly can't, buddy. I've never seen Squid Girl. Second question is, can you sing a song with Won Young Swag 5? Won Young Swag 5 is my best friend, and to be honest, man, we technically did sing a song together. Go to our Tangled movie review. We sang a little bit in the intro of that movie review. That was a lot of fun. The third question by J5 is, have you ever thought of doing a collab with me, JW Universe, and Brian Mendoza? Oh, hell yeah, man. It would be so great just to collab with you and all those others, you know? I'm trying to set up a live stream, everyone, where I could get some YouTubers to come and you could ask us questions. Me and J53518 did our live birthday live stream, and those of you that joined us that very night to celebrate our birthdays, thanks again for that. That was a lot of fun. So I hope to do more live streams, but not just with J53518, hopefully with other YouTubers to come. So I'm trying to get that to work out. Four, can you do an impression of Jeremy Johns?
Oh my gosh, this is Jeremy Johns! Did you know that this girl is so hot right here? Oh yeah! And then if you could see this guy in the storyline, it's like crazy shit! And then you could see that guy right there! And I give this movie an awesome-tacular! What'd you think of this movie? Comment below, let me know! And if you like what you see in her, if you want to see more, click right here to see more!
Name an anime female or females you would date in real life. The chick from Fairy Tail you showed me, man, I forgot her name. I believe it started with an L. I don't remember, but she was pretty hot. I would probably go out with her. No, actually, that wolf chick, I don't know her name, man. You would know, but I would actually go out with the wolf chick. She's really hot, so yeah, I would go out with her. Can you review Dumbo? I do want to someday do Disney Week, where I have a week of reviewing Disney movies. I actually am in the works of trying to get into that. It's just really hard to get that going when I have other things on my channel and stuff going on in my life. But I would like to review Dumbo one day, especially since, unfortunately, we're getting a live-action version of Dumbo now. Seriously, Disney, why are you turning all your beloved movies into live-action? That just shows how lazy Disney can be. I plan to review Dumbo soon, man. I just want to try to get some guest stars, and I want to try to get some catching up to do on my channel. Can you do a review on Necrophiliac? Sorry if I mispronounced that. I haven't seen that, man, so I probably wouldn't, to be honest. Now, Finny Sewer Sore. Sorry if I mispronounced that, Finny. What's your favorite season of South Park? Mine is season 5. I really enjoy South Park. I think it's a good show. Overrated, yes, but I do think it's a good show. It's solid. I reviewed South Park with Sarami Shane 1 Yes Like 5 if you guys want to check that out. Favorite seasons, though, I have seen some very funny South Park ones, but at this moment, I can't really think of one right now, man. I'm a little too lazy to research it, but, you know, all I can say is that I've seen some funny South Park episodes. I like the Walmart one. That one's hilarious. The toilet paper one is also very funny. So, seasons, I can't say, man, but, there are some very funny South Park episodes out there for me. Next one is from Ty Neves. Do you like the Nostalgia Critic? I do like the Nostalgia Critic. I don't watch him all the time, but I'll watch him sometimes. And he's a very funny dude. He's very creative. I like his background stuff. I could definitely tell the dude puts a lot of hard work into his videos. And it's just so hilarious to see the guy just get angry over stuff. Like his video on Alice in Wonderland was just hysterical. The Lorax one was hilarious. A lot of his videos are very funny and they're very creative. So I do like the Nostalgia Critic. I don't watch him all the time, but I do watch him sometimes. And when I do watch him, he entertains the hell out of me. Furry Miss. Have you ever played Happy Wheels? No, I haven't. Were you picked on in school? Yeah, I was in 7th grade. Not going to say the name, but, you know, he was bigger than me. It was in PE. I remember he pushed me through the lockers. I got a big scratch. I got so pissed off that I actually pushed him down. And luckily, the coaches were there to witness it, so I wasn't in trouble, but he was really just in 7th grade. I haven't had any problems with anyone else after that. High school, I had no enemies. I had no bullies to deal with, so that was really good, and high school overall was just a really good experience for me. How many licks does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop? Well, let's see here. A 1, a 2, a 3. I don't know, actually. I just felt like doing that. Will Rainbow Dash ever get her cider? I'm sure she will. What is the meaning of life? The meaning of life is to appreciate the littlest things. Appreciate family, appreciate friends. I think life wants for us to show who we are, what we're capable to do as humans, what is our talent. So I think that's what life is all about. It's about finding your own talent. It's about spending time with your family. It's about appreciating the littlest things in life and just take advantage of every time you have in life, because you're gonna either die young, die old, but however long you have life, just live it. That's how I see life. I see it as a very meaningful thing. And while, yeah, sure, we have crap that goes on in the world, there could be good things to help us go past that. How many Krabby Patties could a SpongeBob cook if a sponge could cook Krabby Patties? Did you want me to say that as a tongue twister, or did you actually want me to answer that? Alright, I'll just leave that as a tongue twister. Also, who would win a fight, Unikitty or Rainbow Dash? I'll say Rainbow Dash. And then one last question, what is love, love, love? Baby, don't hurt me no more. Well, love is just fighting for that special someone. Or are you referring to a song? Because there's actually a song called Love, 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 so. Alright, next one is from Arturk188. I am sorry if I mispronounced that, man. I have some for you, 22 Tiger Dude. Well, thank you, man. What religion do you belong to, if you have any? I am a Catholic. What are your thoughts on the show, Alan Gregory? Oh, dear God. Just when I was forgetting about that show for a long time now. Yeah, Alan Gregory, if you guys don't know what that is, it was an animated series that Fox used to air. It was an animated show with Jonah Hill, with this little kid who has the hots for the 60-year-old principal. It was just, it's a sick show. It's not funny. The humor is so terrible. It's so bad that my brain literally melts and it takes me an hour to connect the pieces to my brain together. It makes me feel so stupid, and I can't believe Jonah Hill, who has a lot of talent and who is a very funny and down-to-earth dude, would do such an atrocious, crappy show like Alan Gregory. So, in other words, man, I hated Alan Gregory, and I'm glad that piece of shit is over. Keith David, too. Keith David was in the show. What the fuck? What is your least favorite cartoon episode? Let's see. I really did not like that love couple class clown episode from Fairly Odd Parents. You know, those two pairings. It's probably one of the worst pairings I've ever seen. From the Fairly Odd Parents, I could think of that. For SpongeBob, if you see my review, Little Yellow Book is my least favorite episode of all time from SpongeBob. There's more from other cartoons, but honestly, I can't really think of more at this moment. What are your thoughts on Breadwinners? I've only seen like 3 episodes of the show, and that's honestly when I get ready for work. You know, nothing's really on, so I'm like, fuck it, I'll watch Breadwinners. I've seen a few episodes, and it's just another example that Nickelodeon is going down the drain. It's not as bad as Sanjay and Craig, though, because, oh, dear God, wow, that's a whole new low for Nickelodeon. But yeah, Breadwinners, it is a bad show. I don't like the show. Not as bad as Sanjay and Craig, though. I really just can't stand that show, period. But Breadwinners is pretty much up there. What is your least favorite episode of Friendship is Magic? I forgot the name of the episode, but my least favorite one is the episode where Trixie makes her return. I can't stand Trixie, and I thought the episode as a whole was boring. It was crap, and I just wasn't very entertained by it, and it actually is my least favorite episode of My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. What's your favorite pre-movie SpongeBob episode? Too many of them. Least favorite pre-movie SpongeBob episode? I'm with Stupid. I just really don't care for that one. Another question for ArtHerc188. I have a question for you, 22 Tiger Dude. Who is your least favorite character in My Little Pony Friendship is Magic? Villain Trixie. I can't stand that bitch. I used to hate Twilight, like in the earlier seasons. She was annoying, she was unlikable. Her character has changed, and I've grown to enjoy Twilight now, so I don't hate Twilight like I did back then. Let's see. Rainbow Dash is a little bit too cocky and can get on my nerves. Let's see. Even though I do like the character, I will say Rarity just because she does get on my nerves sometimes. I like the character, I care about the character, but you know, there are just times where she could get a little annoying. She's all me, me, me. This one's from Blu-ray Evan. Nice. Hey man, what's your favorite movie ever? Too many, dude. What made you start collecting DVDs? Well, the thing is that my family has been buying DVDs since I was very young. I would say I've collected DVDs just slowly throughout my whole life, but I didn't buy movies, you know, more often until really I started my channel and I just started having a job. What made you become a YouTuber? I saw videos from Jeremy Johns, Chris Duckman, Schmoes No, Nick Yakabuchi from Real Screen Review, Stephen Hunt, and the Flick Pick, aka John Flickster. Those 6 guys. Oh, and J53481 started too, because he actually started 2 months before I did. He started in May of 2012. I started in July of 2012. So I would say I had 7 inspirations that year. Those were literally the only YouTubers I was watching. Then I started my own channel, and then I'm discovering more people at the time. Like, I think Brian Mendoza actually started his own channel that year, and Justin watches movies. So it's all like, some of the people I actually know actually started their own channel the same year I started my own channel. And, you know, I'm watching more and more YouTubers now as time goes by. It's just really great to see someone be on camera and express their own opinion. Steelbooks or Digibooks? I don't collect Blu-rays, man. I collect DVDs, but I do see a lot of great stuff that JW Universe puts up with the Digibooks and all that stuff. So I think in terms of looks, I'll say Digibooks. Favorite animated movie? Shit, man. One of them is Monsters University. I love that film. Monsters, Inc., Ratatouille, Toy Story 2 and 3, Finding Nemo, to name off the DreamWorks films, the Kung Fu Panda movies. I love those films. The three Madagascar movies, Shrek 2, I love those films. And I love Robots. I love the original Rio. So there's plenty of animation films that I really love. To name off the Disney ones, Tangled, Wreck-It Ralph, Beauty and the Beast, you name it. A lot of great ones out there. Best cartoon ever, SpongeBob SquarePants. An upset. Look to your left, dude. You see it? You see that wall right there? Yeah. SpongeBob SquarePants. I love the show. I always will. Favorite actor / actress? Okay. There's a lot of but you know, there's too many to think of right now. So for actor, I'll say Tom Hanks. And for actress, I'll actually say Emma Stone, because she's a really good actress. She's very beautiful. Jessica Chastain, she's a very good actress. I would consider her one of my favorites. Natalie Portman, beautiful, very talented. And then to name off the more actors, since I'm naming off actresses, Clint Eastwood, fantastic actor. Morgan Freeman, oh, you bet. Robert Downey Jr., there's a lot of talents out there. Favorite Clint Eastwood film? Gran Torino. I love Gran Torino. Million Dollar Baby, that's another fantastic film. Unforgiven is fantastic. So to name off the ones that come from the top of my head, those three I just mentioned are my favorite films from Clint Eastwood. Favorite DVD you have in your collection? Secret Life of Walter Mitty. I love the slipcover on that movie, and the movie overall just looks so beautiful. So I'm actually going to go with that. I'm actually going to say The Secret Life of Walter Mitty, because out of all the movies I've been buying recently, that's the one that I can't stop looking in terms of, like, its slipcover, how the movie looks. It just looks so beautiful. If you had to find a way to teleport out of a green well in a game created by Danny DeVito before questioning him, what would you do? I would just pretty much hide, and I would teleport to something more safer. Got some questions from Felix Anthony Sayans. Sorry if I mispronounced that, man. All right, what cartoons do you think are going downhill? And name me the reasons why. Family Guy, I will say, even though I do still enjoy that one, I'll say that one's going downhill a little. You know, the characters change. Like, for example, Lois went from this sweethearted mother to this very bitchy mother and just very cruel. Stewie, who goes from being the world dominator to just being gay and very lazy. And then you have Brian, who is very wise, and he still pretty much is now, but, you know, he's very political. He's into religion. So, to name off a few, I would probably go with that one. It's been several weeks since the Animation Domination 2013-2014 ended, so how would you rate the 25th season of The Simpsons, the 4th season of Bob's Burgers, the 12th season of Family Guy, and the 9th season of American Dad? You know, you rate episodes, episode by episode, and it's hard to even decide what you're going to rate each season. So honestly, I'm one of those people that just can't rate seasons unless I'm looking through each episode based on what I rate it, and I could put that all together into one score. I'm sorry, I just don't do that. Which upcoming shows, both live action and animated, are you looking forward to? I'm looking forward to Flash. That's a show I'm honestly really excited to see. I'm actually really excited for the Agent Carter show that's coming. What are some of your favorite episodes of the 5th season of Regular Show? I love the episode where Muscle Man tries to eat every single meat burrito before it's over because he's trying to change for Starla. The episode is called Every Meat Burritos. That one's very funny. I Like You, Hi. That's the episode where Mordecai is starting to have feelings for CJ. Well, I think he has ever since him and CJ have gone over what happened at the New Year's party one, which is another episode I actually really love. I actually love the Take the Cake episode with Mr. Maylard's surprise birthday party because he's not known to get surprised or anything, and Benz is trying to surprise him, and Mordecai and Rigby get Eileen and CJ's help to make the cake since the cake they got was destroyed, but they couldn't take it out of the house. That's an episode that made me laugh my ass off. There's plenty of episodes in season 5 I actually love. I just don't want to name all of them. But season 5, I do think, is actually a very good season. I've been impressed with season 5 so far, and I'm happy what they've been doing with the show. This one's from the Clapper. Hello, new subscriber here. Thank you, Clapper. Welcome to my channel, 22 Tiger Dude. Could you review Penny Foolish? I have already reviewed Penny Foolish. You could check it on my channel right now. And Squid's Visit. I'll review Squid's Visit soon, man. I'm trying to get through all of the requests, so I do have a ton, but I'll eventually review Squid's Visit. Joe Cabimella. Yeah. What are your thoughts on Happy Tree Friends, and what would you rate him? I didn't see Happy Tree Friends. You know, I've only seen maybe a couple of episodes on YouTube, and that's really it. Have you seen Doctor Who? If you have, what do you think of it, and what would you rate it? Never seen Doctor Who. I know a lot of people love that, and it's a very popular show, but I don't watch Doctor Who. Facebook or Twitter? I would say Facebook just because it's more fun to post stuff from there. Twitter, all you do is just tweet, and it's all like, okay, people reply or favorite or retweet. It's just simple stuff like that. Facebook is more fun. You could actually interact with others. You could pretty much post a little more there than what you could do in Twitter. What are your thoughts on the TV show Fargo, and what would you rate it? You know, I actually have been wanting to review Fargo for a while, but it's been a busy summer with work, and I've been having a lot of family from out of town, so also as well as catching up on some videos I've been behind on doing for my channel. I do still make plans to review Fargo, though, but all I could say is that Fargo was an amazing show. Billy Bob Thornton, Martin Freeman, you know, Bilbo Baggins from the Hobbit films. They are phenomenal in the TV show. And Colin Hanks and everyone else, they do a very great job. Also, Key and Peele were in the show. How fucking awesome is that? I love Fargo. Every episode gets more intense, more dark, and it actually is funny in that sick and twisted kind of way. It's very original storytelling, and it's so far the best new TV show I've seen in 2014. All of season 1 with Fargo gets 10 out of 10. Honestly, I love the show from beginning to end. It was just fantastic. What do you think of Doctor Strange casting floating around? I haven't read too much into that, so I honestly don't know. To be honest, Zach Correll. More questions from Felix Anthony Sayens. Favorite old Nickelodeon, Cartoon Network, and Disney Channel show? Alright, old Nickelodeon, Hey Arnold. Love that show, hands down. Cartoon Network. I'm gonna have to say Camp Lazlo. I really love Camp Lazlo. It gave me that nice old school cartoon feel. It was just a very amazing cartoon to me. I love Camp Lazlo. I wish it lasted longer, actually. And then, let's see, Disney Channel. Let's see, and Disney Channel. Come on, there was a cartoon I loved. I loved Kim Possible. I'm gonna actually say Kim Possible. Plus, not to get all weird or anything, but Kim Possible is one of the hottest cartoon characters I've ever seen. Like, damn. Alright, yeah, that got a little weird. What was the best seasons of your favorite shows? When it comes to shows, it really is hard to just choose that one and only season. Unless I give some more bigger thought to it, I really cannot answer that, to be honest, Felix. What was the worst seasons of your favorite shows? Alright. For SpongeBob, I would probably say season 6. I felt like that was just the weakest season of SpongeBob. Top 5 favorite Simpsons, Bob's Burgers, Family Guy, American Dad episodes. And this is a question I cannot answer right away. Same for top 5 least favorite. I can't do the same, you know. When I think top 5, I have to literally sit down and make the list. It's not questions I can answer right away. Which grumpy character do you prefer, Squidward or Benson? Squidward, as of late, I find him more unlikable. And Benson, he's unlikable, but, you know, you could get an understanding as to why. And he has proven in episodes lately that he really isn't a bad boss. He has his moments of being messed up to Mordecai and Rigby, but I don't think he compares to how Squidward is to SpongeBob. So I'm going to have to say Benson. Plus, he makes me laugh when he has a huge tantrum. Like, god damn, those tantrums are huge, but they make me laugh my ass off. Which characters do you think are underrated? Let's see here. Larry the Lobster from SpongeBob, I think he's underrated. Slinkman is pretty underrated. I don't really hear anyone talk about Slinkman from Camp Lazlo. I love Slinkman. Eduardo from Foster's Home seemed like he was underrated. Which characters do you find the most overrated? Okay, let's see. Oh, shit, man. Let's see. You know what? I'll go ahead and say Twilight Sparkle. I do think she's a little overrated. You know, I'm enjoying the character now compared to back then where I really did not like her. But, you know, more people are talking about her, like Applejack or Pinkie Pie. Fluttershy and Pinkie Pie, mainly. So, I'll go ahead and say Twilight. Favorite modern 2010 through present Cartoon Network shows besides regular show? The Amazing World of Gumball. That's a very funny show. I really enjoy that one. No, love that one, actually. The Looney Tunes show. It's not as good as the original Looney Tunes cartoons, and they really underuse Tweety Bird and Sylvester the Cat, which honestly pisses me off about that show. But the Looney Tunes show, I don't think it's as good as regular show or The Amazing World of Gumball. Not even close, to be honest. But I enjoy the Looney Tunes show, so... And then, that's really it. I don't care for Adventure Time. I don't care for Clarence. Teen Titans Go is... Uncle Grandpa, are you fucking kidding me on that? So, favorite modern 2010 through present Nickelodeon shows besides SpongeBob? I really love Tough Puppy. I really enjoy The Fairly Odd Parents. I actually really love The Penguins of Madagascar. What are your favorite voice actors? Tom Kenny. Tara Strong. There you go. Favorite Adult Swim shows, at least two. I don't watch too many Adult Swim shows, to be honest. I know you're thinking of actual Adult Swim shows. I'm gonna say the Aqua Teen Hunger Force show. I really love that show. It's stupid. Weird stuff happens. Really weird stuff happens, but it's a funny show. I find a lot of entertainment out of it, and I would say, actually, my most favorite Adult Swim show. Since you say two, man, I'll go ahead and say Robot Chicken. Even though Robot Chicken, I don't find that great, you know, it has some funny moments, but it's not my favorite. But you did say two, so I'll go ahead and just say Robot Chicken for my second. Even though it's not my favorite. Actually, it's not my favorite at all, period. I got some questions from Mr. Film Jack. Alright. How many Blu-rays, DVDs do you have? I only own two Blu-rays. That is Man of Steel and Prometheus. So, two Blu-rays, DVDs, I'm gonna have to say maybe like 220 DVDs. Around there, probably a little more. What are your top five films of the year so far? Honestly, Jack, I'm going to be honest. I don't like saying my top five in the middle of the year because I feel like if I do that, I'm already going to spoil my top films that I'm going to make for the end of this year. So I don't want to really say that, to be honest. At least not as of right now. Which one are you more excited for? Star Wars Episode 7 or The Avengers Age of Ultron? As much as I love Star Wars and I loved watching them as kids... The Avengers Age of Ultron. Especially with all the set photos that Entertainment Weekly has released, it just got me more and more excited for Avengers Age of Ultron. Which one do you think should make more money? Star Wars Episode 7 or The Avengers Age of Ultron? I'm gonna probably say Star Wars Episode 7 because, you know, there's a lot of people that grew up with Star Wars. They're pretty much seeing the film that they grew up with. And Avengers Age of Ultron, I'm sure, will make a lot of money. But I think Star Wars Episode 7 is possibly going to make more money than The Avengers 2. What editing software do you use? Windows Live Movie Maker. Very simple software, but You know, it gets the job done, and honestly, the easiest software. I try using other softwares. I have a lot of trouble using them, so I'm sticking to the simplest editing software, at least for right now. Which Spielberg film is your favorite? There's a lot. There's E.T., there's Saving Private Ryan, his recent ones, War Horse, Lincoln. So many films, man. The Indiana Jones movies are fantastic. Tarantino, it's Pulp Fiction and Django Unchained. Which Nolan film is your favorite? Batman Begins, The Dark Knight Rises. I love those films. But I also loved Inception, and I also love The Prestige. And then, you know, Interstellar's coming up, and I can't wait for that one. Would you be interested in a Crash Bandicoot film? Is it like Crash the Fox character? Because if you're describing the Fox character, then yes, I would like that film. Has the latest poster for the second SpongeBob movie made you more or less excited for the film? You know, I was skeptical about the film, and then once I saw the poster, I'm all like, I'm sorry. I'm not looking forward to it. Looks terrible. I just hate the idea of them going out in the airline, all CGI-ish. Especially since in the original film, they still go up in airline, but they are still in their traditional 2D animation film. You could check out my video. I titled it, Sponge Out of Water in CGI? What? 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 That's why I titled the video. Check it out. I had things to say about it. Let's just say that. What are some of your favorite TV comedies? Alright, George Lopez. I love George Lopez. The King of Queens is a really good one. The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. I love to watch that one. I'm actually really enjoying the ABC Family show, Melissa and Joey. I actually think that's a really good TV comedy for me. Family Matters, Full House. There's a lot of great TV comedies that I really love. Believe it or not, I actually do really enjoy The Big Bang Theory. I know some people hate that show, and it's totally understandable, but I just find The Big Bang Theory to be very humorous. How do you have so much tiger power? I don't know, man. It just comes to me. The next questions are from It Is Raining Blood. He has a channel. Check it out. Very nice guy. Very cool videos he has. Would you blow out a dying person's birthday candles before they get the chance to for $500? No, I wouldn't, to be honest, man. Yeah, it's $500, but just to do that for that much money, it would make me seem selfish, and to me, it's pretty messed up. If you received a letter from the government saying you must fund World War III, how would you feel? I would feel scared, I would be panicked, and I would just be terrified for my life. Do you think they'll ever find a cure for cancer? You know, I always try to let in a little hope. I hope they do, because I hate cancer. I hate how some people lose their family members through cancer. So, well, not some, a lot actually. So yeah, I would hope they do. Why are teachers so mean? You know, for the most part, I actually had good teachers. I had a couple of mean teachers. It really depends the teacher you have. Is the teacher being mean because he or she wants to push you to be successful? Or is he or she being mean like they're trying to embarrass you on purpose? So I really think it depends what teachers you have. Do you think Clint Eastwood could play an old Batman? I think for his age, I don't think so, to be honest. Maybe 20 years ago he could have worked as old Batman, but right now, you know, knowing the age he has, I don't think he could. If you could choose any actor to play you in a film about yourself, who would you choose? I would choose Brad Pitt to play me, by the way. LOL. let's see. I don't know. For some reason, I keep thinking Logan Lerman? Maybe? Logan Lerman? I don't know. For some reason, I feel like he could pull me off. There's better casting, but I honestly can't think of anyone else. What do you think Anna Paquin would do if I forced kissed her on the lips? I don't know. What is your favorite video from my YouTube channel and why? You enjoyed Movie 43. I totally respect that. I hated that film with a burning passion, but that's great that you enjoyed it, man. You know, pretty much anything you do, man, that's me being honest right there. By the way, my favorite of yours would have to be the live birthday Q&A you did with J5 recently. That video was so much fun. Well, I'm glad you had a lot of fun doing that, man. I hope sometime in the future I'll do more live streams and bring in some other YouTubers to join in. And thank you for asking the questions. You are the one that asked more questions than anyone else in that live birthday Q&A. Can you play any instruments? I myself can play guitar and some piano. Wow. I knew one day I was going to get this question. I'm surprised in my last two Q&As I wasn't asked that question, but I knew today would be the day. So, here it is. I used to play the violin. Why do I say I used to? Because I don't play the violin anymore. I actually do have my violin in my closet with me right now. I just haven't opened it. I just haven't opened my case for it for like 2 years now. Because I graduated high school in June of 2012. And you know, June 2012 was my last day of orchestra and other classes, and it was the last time I ever touched my violin. My violin has been in my closet for the past couple of years, but I just never took it out. It just always stayed there. And that's great that you play guitar and some piano, man. That's awesome. You like to cross-dress? No, I don't. What do you think of the KKK? You know, I don't like going in detail with these kind of topics, man, but I'll just say, no, I don't like the KKK. What do you think the year 2100 would be like? I'm sure technology will be more advanced. I'm sure more changes to it, but that's really all I could say for it. Can you say the following quote in Christian Bale's Batman voice?
I'm sorry I was rude before, but it's difficult for me to express myself when I'm on the verge of exploding in my pants.
There you go, man. What do you think I would look like without the ghost face mask? I honestly can't say, man, unless I actually see your face. What countries would you like to visit? I myself would love to visit Egypt, Italy, and United States of America one day. I'm from New Zealand, by the way, if you're wondering. Oh, cool, man. I would love to visit Italy one day. It just looks like a beautiful place to be in. I heard they've had fantastic pizza over there. The scenery is beautiful. And I'm sure there's a lot of relaxing things you could do in Italy. So that's something I would really love to do one day. Would you pose for Playgirl? I honestly would. No, I would not. What is your dream job? My dream job is to be a film critic. I love to give my honest opinion on films. So I would love to be a film critic because I just love movies. I love going to screenings. I've been going to screenings more often this year than I did last year. So that's really nice. Yeah, that's definitely my dream job, and I hope that will work out for me. But in the meantime, I'm glad my channel is a nice way for me to actually do pretty much my dream job, you could say. Mine is either the lead singer of a rock band or a film actor. Nice. If your celebrity crush barged in through your door right now and proposed to you, what would you say? If it was Selena Gomez, I would say, fuck yes, let's do it. Yeah. Alright, Batman Christian Bale versus James Bond Daniel Craig. Who would win the fight and why? Alright, I would say Batman Christian Bale just because Batman has all the Batman gears. You have a gun with only one bullet and you could only shoot either Justin Bieber or Sarah Silverman. Who would you choose? Honestly, it's just plain cruel. Yeah, I can't stand Sarah Silverman. I can't stand Justin Bieber. But I don't want to shoot them. Like, seriously. Miley Cyrus. I cannot stand that bitch, period. But do I want her dead? No, because that's too cruel right there. PDI Comics, is SpongeBob your favorite cartoon of all time? If so, is it your favorite show of all time? Yes, SpongeBob is my favorite cartoon of all time. Have you ever seen the Super Mario Brothers Super Show? And if so, what's your opinion of it? Oh yeah, the show on the Hub Channel. No, I've never seen it. What are your favorite episodes of SpongeBob you like that everyone else generally hates? I love the episode, One Course Meal. I'm getting a lot of crap because I actually love that one. Like, people are giving me stupid comments like, oh, he loves suicide. He loves to see the character commit suicide. You love an episode about suicide. Oh, man. Look, people, I just love the episode because I actually laugh. It actually is a funny episode, in my opinion. The storyline is very well done, and I actually do enjoy the fact that the writers took risk of making a pretty haunting episode, like going dark. I don't love the episode because I want to see Plankton get killed. I don't like that aspect, and I do agree that Mr. Krabs is a jerk, but it doesn't take away overall what I really feel about the episode. I love One Course Meal. It's based on my opinion, and I would say that's the episode I love that pretty much everyone hates. And Vader R. Chris, what states, places have you been to? I've been to Colorado, I've been to California, I've been to Arizona. I believe when I was little, I've been to Florida, I've been to New Mexico. Do you prefer the older seasons or newer seasons of SpongeBob? No, I enjoy both of the new and old seasons. I'm just wondering what you prefer as a SpongeBob fan. Both of them, to be honest. You know, yes, the new ones have changed since the SpongeBob movie, but it's still a very great show, and I do feel some people are being a little too harsh with SpongeBob, but you know, everyone has their own opinion, and I just gotta respect that. Would you make a video if SpongeBob or The Simpsons ever got canceled? Yeah, I would, because you know I love those shows. I grew up with those shows, and if it does get canceled or end, of course I'm gonna make a video to pay my tribute to the shows I really loved and grew up watching. How would you rank Nickelodeon, Disney Channel, and Cartoon Network from best to worst? Alright, let's see. That's honestly a tough one. Let's see. I'm gonna go with Nickelodeon, Disney Channel, and then Cartoon Network. Because out of all the channels, Cartoon Network has the most crappiest shows. Are you looking forward to Batman vs. Superman? Yeah. I'm still one of those people that's having worries, but I do have hope for it. Are you a Marvel fan or DC fan? I don't read comics, so when I do watch movies, I just criticize based on what I see up on the screen. And DC, yeah, they have Batman and Superman, but look at Marvel. Captain America, Iron Man, Hulk. The list goes endless, and we're going to get more. So I'm going to go ahead and say Marvel for that one. Since you love the animation genre, what do you think of the original Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs from 1937? Oh, it's a classic. I love Snow White. Beautiful animation, very dark storytelling, and very great musical numbers. It's just a very wonderful animation film overall. What do you think of Rob Schneider? I do think he's a funny guy. I do think a lot of people give him a little too much crap. He's been in stinkers and he does try a little too hard, but you know, he's a funny guy, and I'm gonna be honest, I enjoyed his sitcom Rob, which only lasted for one season with a total of 8 episodes. So I was kind of bummed that that got canceled, because I actually thought that was a funny show. But Rob Schneider, he gets a little too much crap in my opinion. I like him. I do think he's a funny actor. Anyone notice how lately he hasn't been in Adam Sandler films? Like, does anyone know if Adam Sandler and Rob Schneider have just been in a fight, or has Rob Schneider just been too busy? Anyone know if they've been in a fight? Because I remember in the past Adam Sandler movies, Rob Schneider would make cameos in them. And now it seems like he isn't. The last time Rob Schneider was in an Adam Sandler film, I believe, was actually the first Grown Ups film. So if anyone knows anything about that, tell me, because I'm honestly curious to know. What did you think about the Big Hero 6 trailer coming this November? Oh yeah, the full-length trailer came up, and I actually think it looks pretty good. It looks like it will be a very fun animation film. Honestly, not pretty good, awesome. I think the film looks like it will be awesome. Hopefully it's not a letdown like Frozen is, and hopefully it's more on the Wreck-It Ralph and Tangled level for me, because in terms of recent Disney films, Wreck-It Ralph and Tangled have been amazing. And Frozen is just, it's in the middle. But I hope Big Hero 6 will be up there with Wreck-It Ralph and Tangled, in my opinion. Have you ever seen an eclipse? Yeah, I actually have. You know, there was an eclipse that happened back in April, and then I actually saw how the moon looked red. Like, I actually saw the red blood moon. Which SpongeBob character bothers you more, Squidward or Mr. Krabs? Squidward is a jerk, he's grumpy. Mr. Krabs, I'm gonna say him slightly more because of how greedy he is and how he doesn't know how to be a parent. Like, seriously, Pearl could be a bitch. She is such a bratty bitch, and Mr. Krabs doesn't do anything about it. He really does not know how to parent, so I'm going to have to say Mr. Krabs on that one, honestly. Have you ever seen any of the Rush Hour movies? If you have, what do you think about them? I really enjoy all three of the Rush Hour movies. They're really stupid and really cheesy movies, but they're a lot of fun. What do you think of all the trouble Justin Bieber has been getting into lately? Kids getting more messed up, man. More and more messed up. I'm honestly surprised Selena Gomez is back with him. Wouldn't it be awesome if Justin Bieber actually got deported back to Canada? I guess if he were to learn his lesson and learn how to be, you know, a better person. In that sense, yeah, I would think so. Because look, honestly, even though I'm not a fan of Justin Bieber, I do hope that guy can get his head out of his ass and start to make good decisions again. Do you hate the Star Wars prequels? Honestly, I have not seen the Star Wars prequels since I was a little kid. You know, I've only seen each of the films once, and that's in theaters. If you could make a sequel to any movie, what would it be? I don't know, honestly. If you could revive any TV show, what would it be? George Lopez, the TV show. I know George Lopez already has his other show, St. George, which I actually am really enjoying. But you know, I still miss his original show because I feel like there was more of a connection with the characters there and I felt like more funny stuff could happen. Even when the show ended, it still left room for more episodes and we really didn't technically get to see Carmen one last time, and it would have been great to see episodes where Carmen comes to visit from college and just to see where Max is going. So I feel like that show does need more seasons. I really feel like that show wasn't quite ready to end yet. It would have been great to see the episodes where George is the manager. It would be nice to see how he would handle that. I would love that to be revived. My Wife and Kids, that show ended in a huge cliffhanger. And, you know, we never saw what happened next. We just know that it ended with Jay being pregnant, and then the show ends. Everyone that was in that show is now older, but I mean, then again, we could have at least seen how the show goes with them older now. I would actually still be interested in still seeing the show, even if the cast is now older. What is your favorite and least favorite music genre? Favorite is rock and country, not metal rock, but you know, rock like Guns N' Roses, AC/DC, so I would say 80s, and rap is honestly my least favorite. You know, there's some good rap songs, but for the most part, I'm just not really rap material, honestly. Who is your most favorite movie director? I have too many favorite movie directors, to be honest, so. But to name off some, Steven Spielberg, Christopher Nolan, Quentin Tarantino's a really great one. Peter Jackson, there you go. Peter Jackson's another fantastic director. Have you ever watched Ed and Eddie? Oh, of course. I grew up watching Ed and Eddie. I liked watching the show, but I just don't love it. Because I remember I had friends at my school saying they love Ed and Eddie. And it's all like, my problem with that show mainly is that pretty much almost everyone is a huge douchebag. Whether they're douchebags all the time or sometimes. What is the best movie you've seen this year? I honestly don't want to spoil that. I want to wait until the end of the year to really reveal that. How many posters do you have in your room? Well, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. I have 27 posters in this room. Have you played any video games recently? No, honestly, I haven't. I'm still saving up for a PS3. I'm actually going to get it very soon. In terms of new games, no, I haven't. All I know is that once I get my PS3, I'm going to start playing the 4th Sly Cooper movie because I've been dying for the past 1.5 years to play that game now, and I just want to finally get to that game because I grew up with the Sly Cooper games, and I love those games. And I do want to play the new SpongeBob game, Plankton's Robotic Revenge, so not only can I play that, but I could review that for you guys, because I even know some of you guys have been requesting me to review that. The thing is that I just haven't played that game yet, but once I get a PS3 and I buy the SpongeBob game, I will play it and I will review it. Have you ever been to Valley Fair? If so, what is your favorite ride? I've never heard of Valley Fair, so I have never been to it. Favorite and least favorite Simpsons character? Homer. I love Homer. Just a bumbling idiot. Least favorite? I will say Nelson's my least favorite. Even though, as the show progresses, you could kind of see why Nelson is the way he is now, because he's had a hard life. So it's like, even the characters that are unlikable, you could feel for them. Nelson, I'll go ahead and say, is my least favorite, though. I don't hate him. I don't hate him. I actually find him quite likable for the most part, but he could be too mean to Bart for no reason, so. Favorite musical number from SpongeBob. I love Best Day Ever. I love Fun. I love the song from the ending of Hello Bikini Bottom, and even the one in the beginning of Hello Bikini Bottom. The Gary Come Home one, that's a very great one, and definitely the saddest SpongeBob song ever. What's your favorite color? I would have to say blue. I have another question from Joe Kevin Mella. What was the worst show in your opinion that has ever been shown on Animation Domination? Alan Gregory. Enough said. Daniel the Movie Buff. He's a very nice guy. Check out his channel. A lot of movie related stuff from the dude. Very passionate about it. But he only asked me two questions. Favorite films of all time. I could name some of my favorite films of all time. Singing in the Rain. Inception. The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, the Indiana Jones films. I have a lot of favorite films. I answered this question earlier, but like I said, for favorite actor, I'll go with like Tom Hanks, Morgan Freeman, actress for Natalie Portman. I would actually say Jennifer Lawrence is my favorite. Not because she's hot. Well, she is really hot, but she's really talented, and for her to win an Oscar at 22 years old is really impressive, so you go, Jennifer Lawrence. What is your favorite movie franchise? Indiana Jones. The Dark Knight movies. I would say the Dark Knight movies, Indiana Jones, The Lord of the Rings. Those are all very great movie franchises to me. What's the worst movie you've ever seen? Not fun bad, but so bad it's just awful and irritating. Whew, okay. My worst movie of last year in 2013 is Scary Movie 5. I've seen a lot of shitty films, but I'm going to name off the one that still burns my mind to this day because of how atrocious it is, and that is Scary Movie 5. Okay, I've seen A Haunted House 2 earlier this year, and even though that's a horrible film too, it does not compare to how shitty Scary Movie 5 was, because there was pretty much not anything funny or anything remotely good. I did mention in my review how Terry Crews was tolerable. Like, he's the only one that was actually kind of decent, but he wasn't even enough to for me to give some points to the film. Scary Movie 5 is atrocious. It is so painful to sit through. It is not fun, and that it's so bad it's good. It's just bad. Like, it is so bad. Have you ever been recognized by fans in public? So far, not yet. This one's from Tristan Matthew, the one that comments on my SpongeBob videos a lot. Thank you for that, man. Will you ever make your own top 5 worst SpongeBob episodes videos sometime? I'm reviewing a ton of episodes, but I do not want to make that video until I've reviewed every bad episode of SpongeBob, in my opinion. And I want to make sure I'm not missing any episodes I find bad. I want to make sure I make a consistent top 10 worst SpongeBob episodes. I do want to make that. I am making plans for that, but I don't see it happening until I'm actually done reviewing every single episode. What is your favorite cartoon besides SpongeBob? Okay, regular show. I would even go out of my way and say The Amazing World of Gumball. Camp Lazlo was a really good one. Hey Arnold is also fantastic. My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. Yes, I am a brony for those that don't know. Looney Tunes is very fun to watch. Tom and Jerry, not the new cartoon. That one's just fine, but the old school original Tom and Jerry. Who's your favorite SpongeBob character? I'm gonna say Sandy just because she has a lot of personality to her. And she's just a really enjoyable character, and a character that I hate the writers are underusing. What is your favorite movie? I have too many favorites, and I don't want to really repeat myself on these questions, but Indiana Jones, Inception, just to name a couple. Do you like video games? If so, what are your favorites? Alright. I love the Sly Cooper games. I love the Jack games. Those are the games I loved playing the most. And I'm not the biggest violent video games person, but I honestly do have a lot of fun with the Gears of War games, as crazy and twisted as that sounds. I just love using a chainsaw and chainsawing a person. What is your favorite video you've ever made? I'm gonna be honest, the recent one I've done is called Movies to Watch for Father's Day. That's where everyone says the movie they think is great to watch for Father's Day. Me and Sonarius J picked the movie we think is good, and I had guest stars in that video. It was probably my biggest collaboration video ever on this channel so far. I had Movie Man Menzel, founder of the We Live Film channel, in the video. I had Down in Movies in there. I had CNN IMAX. I had Movie Man Chad, Justin Watches Movies, J53518 was in there too. So yeah, that video was just really fun to do. The Valentine's Day King 1 and 2, Valentine's Day King to the Rescue, and Valentine's Day King Fights the Dallas Bear. Please check out those videos, you guys. Those were a lot of fun to make. The next questions are from Joe Cabemela. Alright. What's the worst Simpsons episode you've ever watched? Mine is Mo Goes from Rags to Riches. There's a ton of Simpsons episodes out there. And it's like SpongeBob. While the show does have good episodes, it has some really bad episodes. I'm gonna have to say it's the season 18 episode Kill Gil Volumes 1 and 2. It's been a long time since I've seen that episode, but I remember I just watched that episode bored out of my mind. I forgot the character that was in the episode, but there was a character that annoyed the living fuck out of me, and I just couldn't stand that episode. It's called Kill Gil Volumes 1 and 2, and at the top of my head, that might be one of the worst ones. I don't know if it's the worst, it might possibly be the worst, but just in terms of bad, that episode, it's not even bad, it was just atrocious. What are your thoughts on the Batman and Robin movie? Oh, as a movie, it's a piece of shit. As a comedy, it's one of the best comedies ever made. Watch that movie as a comedy, it's hilarious. But if you watch it as a serious movie, then yeah, it is flat out terrible. I'll be honest, I'll watch that movie just for the stupid, silly moments and Arnold Schwarzenegger's cheesy Mr. Freeze lines. So, I'm not gonna lie, the movie's a piece of shit, but I'll actually watch it if I need something terrible and just gosh darn trashy to watch. Which TV show rating would you give to each of the shows? New Girl, The Mindy Project, Modern Family, The Middle, Brooklyn Nine-Nine, Dad's, How I Met Your Mother, Two Broke Girls and Two and a Half Men. Whew, wow. Joe, that was a handful right there, my friend. Okay, I'm gonna be honest, I have not seen pretty much most of those shows. Okay, Brooklyn Nine-Nine, I'm still catching up in that show. I've only seen 5 episodes of it, but so far it's a hilarious show. For Brooklyn Nine-Nine, I'll go a 9.5. I'm sure it'll go to a 10 if I watch more episodes, but as of right now, it's a 9.5. New Girl is like, I'll go an 8 out of 10 on New Girl. I really enjoy it. Plus, come on, it's Zooey Deschanel, one of the most beautiful and cutest actresses working today. Dad's, only seen the pilot episode. It was god-awful. I'm not going to review the show as a whole, but as a pilot episode, I'm going to give it like a 2 out of 10. I'll probably watch maybe 2 or 3 more episodes of Dad's before I could actually give it a rating, but as a pilot episode, it's like a 2 out of 10. How I Met Your Mother, only seen like a few episodes of the show, maybe like 10 episodes, so I can't give my rating on that. Two Broke Girls, I've seen only the first episode of it. I didn't like it. I did want to give the show more chances, though. I just lost track of it and kept forgetting about it. Modern Family, I enjoy that one. Maybe a 7.5 for that one. It's not like one of my favorite shows or anything, but it is a good show. And it's good for me to get some laughs from time to time. The Mindy Project, I've never watched. And 2.5 Men... Yeah, I've been watching the recent season just to see how much lower the show can go. Yeah, it's going down the drain. I'll probably go like a 3.5 for 2.5 Men. What are your thoughts on Seth MacFarlane, Cosmos? I've only seen like 5 minutes of it, honestly, so I can't give my overall thoughts. Family Guy or American Dad? I'm gonna honestly have to say Family Guy. What are your thoughts on American Dad moving to TBS? I guess it'll be good for TBS to actually bring new episodes of an animated show. So that's good on TBS's part. But for Fox, I really would prefer just to watch American Dad along with the other Animation Domination premieres. So, I mean, of course, I'll watch new episodes on TBS. Don't get me wrong. I'll still watch the new episodes, but it's just going to feel weird not seeing it become part of Animation Domination anymore. So, I'm not going to lie. It kind of bums me out. Are you looking forward to Batman vs. Superman? Like I said earlier in this Q&A, I have hope for it. I'm just mostly excited to see it. Have some worries. This isn't really a question, but it's a fact about your favorite cartoon. Did you know that SpongeBob was originally going to be an Adult Swim cartoon? Holy crap. I did not know that, but that is interesting to know, so thank you for giving me that fun fact, Joe. Yeah, SpongeBob as an Adult Swim cartoon. I could only imagine what they would have done. Brian Griffin from Family Guy or Roger Smith from American Dad? You know, as political and religious as Brian could get, you know, I think he's a better character than Roger. Roger just annoys me. The stuff he says, the stuff he does for the most part, absolutely annoys me. I actually hate Roger so much that I wish he got killed off from American Dad. I would probably enjoy American Dad more if Roger was no longer in the show. Good for those that do enjoy the character Roger. Of course, I respect your opinion, but I cannot stand Roger. I hate that character. So I'm going to have to say Brian Griffin. What are your thoughts on the Flash and Gotham trailers that are coming out this fall? Flash I'm looking forward to. Gotham, the trailer doesn't really interest me. It just looks meh. I'll give it a chance and I'll review the pilot episode for you guys once it comes out. But it just doesn't interest me. Have you ever dreamt about meeting SpongeBob and living in Bikini Bottom? I actually have a couple of times. It was pretty nice. What's the worst Treehouse of Horror segment you have watched? Mine is that one when Homer communicates through his cards. Can't remember the name right now, but it was awful. Let's see. Yeah, Treehouse of Horror does have some really terrible segments. I can't remember though. Let's see. Shoot, I honestly can't remember right now. Were you glad Jersey Shore got canceled? Dude, fuck yes. Fuck Jersey Shore. What's your best and least favorite Animation Domination show? Best, I'm gonna have to say Simpsons. Worst is Alan Gregory. And last question, what's your favorite Harry Potter film? I'm gonna have to say The Goblet of Fire. That movie was awesome. Next question is from Sauzuki D. Aizen-sama. I'm sorry if I mispronounced that, by the way. Do you think technology is improving the society we live in? I think for the most part it does. Like, technology, just like anything else, it'll have its ups and will have its downs. But for the most part, I do think it is. What episodes of SpongeBob do you think have good morals in it? I would say fun, you know the song. The way they say, F is for friends who do stuff together, U is for you and me, N is for anywhere and anytime at all down here in the deep blue sea. Hello Bikini Bottom, I would actually say, had good morals too. You know, it had messages about not giving up, just trying to achieve your dreams, follow your heart. Do you think that we're being watched upon? I'm a conspiracy theorist. I think we are, to be honest, which is scary. Who is your favorite character in Dragon Ball Z and why? It's a cliched answer, but I'm gonna have to say Goku. You know, he's a very good father, he's a very good protector, he has very awesome powers, and even though he's a human with powers, he feels like a real human, and you could really get behind his character. What is your favorite country? I haven't been to any countries, you know, USA is pretty much the only country I'm in. I would love to visit Italy, so maybe I'll see Italy for that one, even though I haven't been there yet, but I mean, it looks beautiful. Yours is Japan. Nice, man. What will you be reviewing after you finish with SpongeBob Reviews? Nothing else. The SpongeBob reviews are so hard to get to, especially when I have a lot of messages telling me, when is this episode going to be reviewed? When is this episode going to be reviewed? I have so many requests, and there's only so many I could handle at this point, so yeah, I do not want to review any more episodes or shows after SpongeBob. I hope to actually finish through all of SpongeBob as fast as possible so I don't have to stress out about it anymore. And I have a lot of fun doing them, but it's hard to please everyone that requests me to review the episodes. So after SpongeBob, I'm just gonna focus on like my movie reviews and such. Like the new episodes, of course I'll review them. I just mean in terms of like the other episodes, like season 1, season 2, season 3, you know, there's just too many episodes to get to. What is your current job? Right now, I work at, Hold on. I work at Pizza Hut. Pretty cool job, I can't complain. Next questions are from the Broadster Boy. The Broadster Boy. I hope I pronounced that, man. I'm sorry if I didn't. What is your opinion on the SpongeBob episode Pet Sitter Pat? A cross between a Pal for Gary and Your Mine and Mine. Two of the worst episodes of the show. I think it's my new least fave episode. I actually really enjoy Pet Sitter Pat, and it's funny how you mentioned that, man, because before I started filming this Q&A, I was actually watching the episode from my TV. Here are my top 5 least fave. Demolition Doofus, Little Yellow Book, You Know Why. Yeah, my worst SpongeBob episode of all time. I cannot stand Little Yellow Book. A Pal for Gary, One Course Meal, and number 1's Pet Sitter Pat. That is all for Q&A and the summertime. And you could also say a celebration for my 2-year anniversary here on YouTube. Thank you for all the questions, everyone. I had a lot of fun answering these questions. I started on this channel on July 27th, 2012. And I want to thank for everyone that has been there for the beginning. Everyone that has been following my channel since last year or even this year. The new subscribers that have been coming in, thank you so much for your support, your views, your comments, your likes. Thank you so much to everyone. This is 22 Tiger Dude, and don't forget that I will always have
Tiger Power!